This fight. One should be a good one. A very distinct possibility of a title challenge sometime in 2017 for the winner. Big prize on offer. Some might say a whopper.
Both fighters want nothing more than to get back to that title shot. And that was a Burger King reference there from Steve Dawson. But we're seeing a nice relaxed style from Yokota. His nickname is Hage Haya, which means fast baldy.
Which is fantastic, isn't it?
By
it's a great nickname.
Teammates. But we could have a battle of the best nicknames here between the Situ-Asian Martin Nguyen and Fast Baldy.
I've got to give it to Fast Baldy, I'm afraid. But Nguyen has an awful lot to offer above and beyond nicknames here. In comes that flying teep kick from Yokota. And Nguyen was alert enough to back away from that and the follow-up punches. You can see he's cocking that right leg, Yokota, all the time, just looking to do something with it.
Nguyen has told me that he wants to be a little bit more patient in this fight. He's usually, he kind of lets emotions take over and he rushes in and he makes a little bit of mistakes sometimes. So he wants to be a little more patient and he wants, really wants to be relaxed and composed in the, at least the first round of this fight.
Just as Yokota came in, Nguyen's overhand right looked to land. Caught quite a bit of glove, I think. That's how focused he is and how sharp the 27-year-old is.
We saw some of previous Nguyen's fights. He's got a big overhand right, and you can see the way Yokota is kind of inching his chin out there. He's not really keeping his chin tucked, and he just got caught right there by a right hand. So he's got to keep that chin a little bit down because Nguyen's got a powerful right hand.
He's throwing it, he's faking it. It's gonna be the dominant weapon in these early moments anyway. There it is again, countering the left jab. It came over the top of the jab. And Yokota will have had a good view of that already. Let's see what he's gonna do about it. The way Nguyen beat Christian Lee, who had such a lot of attention and deservedly so, it was something of a destruction and really raised his profile at the back end of a very, very substantial 14 months for this Australian fighter, the Situ-Asian.
Action!
See how composed and relaxed Yokota is. He's threatening that foot. He's really kind of lifting that back leg up, sort of threaten that rear leg push kick.
That overhand right is genuinely overhand, isn't it? The elbow is actually higher than the glove when it lands.
Yeah, Martin Nguyen throws a beautiful right hand, like he's throwing a baseball almost with that right hand. But and the way Yokota's got his hands down and his chin out, that's like, it plays perfectly into that weapon of Nguyen's. Lots of feints, though, coming from Yokota.
Yeah, there are a lot.
So as you can see, it's kind of affected Martin. Like, he doesn't really know exactly what's coming from Yokota.
He wants that right leg, doesn't he, to... Oh, there's a big overhand right counterpunch. And he's certainly hurt, and Olivier Goss jumps in, and Martin Nguyen has done it again. Watch out for the fast start from Christian Lee. It's very much his signature. He doesn't hang about.
By Christian Lee. He's actually slowed down quite a bit. He's kind of understanding composure and how to be relaxed, but he can explode at any minute.
Oh,
and
a right hand
landed by Martin Nguyen.
Really cuffed him, didn't he? Got a clean shot in there. By far the biggest step up for Christian Lee is what Martin Nguyen represents. And Christian got back in with a left hand there that also caught his opponent fairly cleanly. So a good punch each from these men in the opening seconds.
That overhand right is real dangerous from Nguyen because Christian kind of keeps his posture really high and his head looks like it's really elevated, so he doesn't kind of tuck the chin in. So he's susceptible to that overhand right from Martin Nguyen.
It's Lee very much in pursuit mode, as we thought it might be.
Nice catch there on the kick, spins around, takes control, and this is where Martin Nguyen wants to get this fight. He wants to make it dirty, wants to make it gritty, and he likes to drag these fights down to the ground. Trying to single leg break takedown, but Christian pops right back up.
He did so well to land on his feet there. Looked for a moment as if he'd be landing on his head.
Very
athleticism
agile.
And flexibility, agility, that's right, exactly the word we were looking for.
There's another one of those big right hands coming from Nguyen, but Christian ducks under it. We have ourselves a fight, folks.
What an arc to that uppercut from Nguyen, which I'm not sure that it connected, but sent out a message, didn't it?
When I saw this fight on the card, I knew that this one could be the Fun 88 fight of the night.
What a decent overhand right that was from Nguyen as Lee came in.
He's thrown out a stiff jab there. He's got an awkward guard. He keeps a very wide guard, very wide stance. Not your typical boxing stance or Muay Thai stance.
Good left jab from Lee there, but it's that counter overhand right from Nguyen that he's got to be careful of when he throws that jab.
Nice. I like how he threw that overhand right, stepped forward with the right foot, and then came with a left overhand.
And Lee's been quite adept just in the last 20 seconds of getting out of the way. But he caught that one. And bounce straight back up again.
That's it, man. Christian's got to get his chin down. His head's really high in the air. And Nguyen is taking advantage of that with these big overhands.
Can't take your eyes off this one for a second. Good ramrod left jab from Christian Lee.
Now Christian's starting to get a little bit more compact in his stance. Again, another overhand right,
kick.
Steve.
Yeah, he threw the kick and was exposed to the right hand, wasn't he? These counters from Nguyen are expert punches.
Will we see Christian Lee in the second round? And that's the question on everybody's mind.
The energy, the sharpness of youth, very apparent from Lee, but you can just see that little bit more seniority from Nguyen. A little bit more cleanliness to his work.
Well, he's timing these overhands perfectly. Christian's got to keep that chin tucked. Not let him get caught by one of these big overhand rights, or lefts for that matter.
Christian Lee hasn't seen an opponent like this in the ONE Championship game, so that was a good right hand, and it set Nguyen stumbling it, and Nguyen's in trouble.
And Lee just follows up.
Nguyen counts on this. This could be his opportunity. Gets in close, that head is exposed to possible knees. Lee bounces back up, and he goes back down again. He's certainly shaken up.
Christian's hurt, Steve. Christian's hurt. Big left hook landed by Nguyen, started this onslaught, and Nguyen is jumping all over it.
Could already be the Fun 88 fight of the night, this one. You just cannot take your eyes off it.
He's kind of got him in a guillotine here, sort of a modified choke.
Oh, it looks very clean as well.
He's kind of lacing his hand around
under
his
the chin. I'm not sure how he's getting through this.
Christian's fighting, he might be out.
Watching in 128 countries around the world, you've got to be on the edge of your seat. And ONE Championship needed to have only sold the edge of the seats here inside of Stadium Nagara, because everyone is on the edge of their seats. Southpaw to orthodox, switching stance for Martin Nguyen. Gafarov fires a roundhouse kick, Nguyen catches it on the forearm. Switching stance again, the Australian Vietnamese martial artist.
Gafarov pushing forward. He likes to throw big, flashy kicks because he's not scared to go to the ground. But that's exactly what he wants. He wants to take this fight to the ground, control and dominate his opponents.
Gafarov does a great job of curling these knees to the orbital. Looks to take the back here at Martin Nguyen. He's going to try and climb him and slap a rear naked choke that way. To no avail, Nguyen defends again. And now the corking knees from the Aussie.
True to his word so far, his defense in the grappling area has been stellar against that rear naked choke, Michael.
Nguyen shrugs him off.
Nice punch.
The chin a little high here on Gafarov. Now he puts the hands up. Can Nguyen capitalize? Maybe the jab to the overhand right. It's a bread and butter combination for the Aussie. And there it is! Good night, Irene! certainly some hard instructions for the Australian. Even first round, says the heavyweight champion, Brandon Vera. Of course, in one championship, our contest are scored as overall, not round by round. Turning back kick there from Folayang, looking for the sternum.
Look at the stance of Nguyen, hands down, inching forward. He's getting ready, he's getting ready, look at him.
Jab to overhand right. It's the bread and butter combination of Martin Nguyen. Folayang has found success so far to the inside and outside lead thigh of the Aussie.
I like how he's eating up that thigh. It's going to slow Nguyen down. He's not able to step and plant off that left leg and throw that big right hand or his very powerful lead hook. He's got a wonderful left hook that he was able to really rock Christian Lee with.
Goes hunting with a jaw with the legs here. Does Eduard Folayang, then goes downstairs. Folayang still on the outside. Nguyen at center cage. There's the leg kick from Folayang. Little fake of the right hand there from Nguyen. Folayang turning back kick, trying to find the liver. Just got to tuck it under that ninth and tenth rib on the right side of the body of Martin Nguyen to effectively connect to the liver. Goes a little higher there off the left leg of the champion. Well, they're both champions. Competing for Folayang's belt. Oh, the high kick from Folayang! Tried to loop the shin around the back of the neck. Double underhooks here from Martin. And just pulls him off. Folayang goes headhunting again. The power now coming through on Eduard Folayang's salvos.
Nguyen seems very concerned with his hair. Beautifully timed leg kick again by Folayang.
Folayang establishing his power. Here in the second round, we are set for five. First time ever in one championship history. Champion versus champion. The featherweight champion, Nguyen. Oh, the big finish! It's scored by Iran!
Ready? Two!
We could be in for a good old-fashioned slugfest. Nguyen training out of Hard Knocks. Ong Lan Sung, TL Tang in his corner tonight. Jadambaa, so much strength. So much power. If he puts Martin Nguyen on his back, Jadambaa's got those meat hooks, those massive anvils of fists that can rain down punches in the ground and pound.
Like how Nguyen opened up with that lower leg kick. Start the movement of Jadambaa. Jadambaa likes to plant that lead leg and then start throwing wide-angled shots. He doesn't really throw a lot of linear punches. He throws a lot of hooks, a lot of uppercuts, a lot of overhand rights. And I like how Nguyen's immediately starting to attack that lower leg because Jadambaa can't plant off that lead leg.
Look out for the overhand rights of Martin Nguyen. It's the bread and butter punch. I say bread and vegemite punch of the Australian. He used it to win the featherweight title from the seemingly unstoppable Marin Gafarov. And then he used it to knock out Eduard Folayang to win the World Lightweight Championship. And he timed it, thread it to the forehead of Jadambaa tonight. Long-reaching jab from the champion. Jadambaa, the former world champion. Swings low to Nguyen. Nguyen says he's never trained as hard as he did over in Florida with Henry Hooft and Ong Lan and TL Tang. Front kick there from the champion. Jadambaa, who's been itching, who's been waiting for this opportunity, this chance to get back into contention, to get another tilt at the strap. He wants more around that muscular waist.
Martin's starting to touch Jadambaa very slowly, very methodically. You start to see what's landing, what's not. But what now, what's landing right now is that lower leg kick. He's hit him a few times in the head, and that hand is, that left hand of Jadambaa is slowly starting to drop. And I think Martin sees it just like I do, and he's gonna start to throw that overhand right.
Jab from Nguyen. Just seeing, as Mitch said, what Jadambaa has to offer. Overhand right there from the former world champion. Drift back to center circle. Jab again from Nguyen. High kick from Nguyen.
Jadambaa is also being very cautious. He's not being reckless at all. He's slowly inching forward. Just he's also thrown out that jab, which is not something he loves to throw.
That's that roundhouse kick under the left arm of Jadambaa. Jadambaa just massive traps and a huge back and enormous deltoids of the Mongolian. Roundhouse kick there from Nguyen. Front kick from the Aussie. Jadambaa threads the jab to the right hand. Had the power, didn't have the distance, nor the timing. Nguyen being very careful, methodically selecting each strike. Not overexerting himself, not leaving himself open to a counter. He's got tremendous respect for the former world champion from Mongolia. But as Mitch said earlier, the team believes they've found a chink in the armor of Narantungalag Jadambaa.
And see, when Martin steps forward, he plants his left foot. That's when Jadambaa is throwing his leg kicks. And you can see the difference between the two. Martin's throwing his leg kicks and Jadamba's kind of riding them. But when Martin steps forward, that's when Jadamba's landing and the full weight of that leg kick is impacting Martin's leg.
A beautiful Brazilian kick there from Martin Nguyen. Otherwise known as a question mark kick. Fakes downstairs low, then arcs over the top to the head of the opponent. Jadambaa, a little tentative here, Mitch, in the first round for your liking.
That leg kick, though, that lower leg kick, it's because all the weight is on Martin's leg when he's starting to throw it. You can start to see him shuffle a little bit. I don't think Martin liked that last leg kick. Jadambaa's being a little tentative, yes. He's not throwing forward, but he's picking him apart. He's throwing that jab out there. Jadambaa's an experienced striker. He's had over 29 kickboxing matches against some of the greats, so he knows what he's doing in this situation.
Jadambaa used to compete at the highest level in kickboxing. He was a K1 Max competitor. Took on the best of the best. Left hook there from Jadambaa. Final 10 seconds. Left hook from Nguyen. Nicely done from the champion. Jadambaa goes downstairs, kicks the chin. We are going to go into the second round for the Featherweight Championship of the World live from Manila, the Philippines.
Interesting. They're trading low kicks. That's the only thing. There's Brooke Nguyen, Martin Nguyen's beautiful wife sitting right behind us, I do believe. Let's take a look at some of the past action. Here's Martin baiting Jadambaa in, waiting for Jadambaa to come forward, and right as he did, right as Jadambaa was throwing that right hand, Martin Nguyen caught him with a left hook, touched him on the forehead. But the interesting thing in that round was the leg kicks. It was the difference between the two, the placement of those leg kicks, and how the weight distributed was affecting them. Because right now, if you look at right now, they're standing, right? I don't think Martin wanted to sit and let that leg kind of settle in. Jadambaa's taking a seat. That tells you a lot. It'll be interesting to watch the movement of Nguyen. That's what he's known for.
Guys,
that
corner,
beautiful
corner.
Side-to-side movement that sets up that big right hand. If Jadambaa keeps kicking that lead leg, it's really going to slow down the movement of Nguyen.
Second round set for five. Great to see the hashtag.
Trending
on Twitter right now. A touch glove for the second of five. Champion Martin Nguyen, the former champion tonight, the challenger, Jadambaa Narantungalag. What Jadambaa has to offer again, Martin Nguyen. Very cerebral performance so far from the Vietnamese Aussie. Front kick from Jadambaa. Roundhouse kick to the liver there from Nguyen. One of two Nguyens on tonight's card. Earlier on, we saw reality TV star B. Nguyen make a successful one championship debut, her win over Dwiono Retno Wulan of Indonesia. Good body shot there, tipping to the belly button from Nguyen. Overhand right, the money shot of Martin Nguyen. Goes downstairs, you see.
Ooh, that one hurt Jadambaa.
Jadambaa, Jadambaa's left leg is hurt.
This is
host, Misha Tate. If you want to see more awesome ONE Championship content, make sure you click that subscribe button. Click it so you don't miss it.